My name is Rachel Rabo. Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today, I'm going to show you how to create a custom SharePoint list for a customer complaints database. And what this means is that you are trying to get the information of your customers, of your customer complaints filed in your Microsoft form, which they all have access to. So without going through the stress, you can easily automate that Microsoft form to be able to get the information, to be able to get the data of the complaints and the information of that customer into your SharePoint list in order to store them. So today I'm going to show you how to create a SharePoint list. So don't forget to like this video and hit on the subscribe button. So if you can notice, we're already on our SharePoint site. So I'm going to go ahead and create a SharePoint list. So I'm going to click on New. Then click on List. So if you can notice, we have different options of creating a list. We have the option of creating from blank. We also have the option of creating from an Excel sheet. That is where you can easily upload an Excel sheet into your SharePoint list. And we also have an option of creating from an already existing list. So we're just going to go ahead and create from a blank list. Then I'm going to give this list a name, which will be customer complaint list. So you can give the SharePoint list any name you want. Okay, one thing you have to take notice of when giving your SharePoint list a name, you have to give it a name that is easily identifiable, that okay, when you see it, you understand that okay, this is what the SharePoint list is about. And there's also one great thing about a SharePoint list is that when you're creating your SharePoint list, there's an option where you can give like a description where what the SharePoint list is about. So I'm just going to skip that and click on create. So if you can notice, after creating my SharePoint list, we actually have title here, which is default, which is a default column. So I'm just going to work on this because with this title here, it's actually required. So I'm going to work on it to change it from a required column to a non-required column. So I'm just going to go to click on the settings icon, then click on list settings. So I'm just going to come down and click on, if you can notice, you have your title and you have it that it is required. So I'm just going to click on title and change it from require that this column contains information to no, change it from yes to no, then come down and click on OK. So after taking that step, I'm just going to go back to my SharePoint list by just clicking on the name of my SharePoint list, which is customer complaints list. So if you can notice now, I want to add the information, like the data I want to save on my SharePoint list. And I'm just going to be able to do that, I'm going to click on add column. So from here, you can see these different things here. They are all data types. We have our single line of text, our multiple line of text, and the others. So they are all data types. And I'm actually trying to create a column right now. And the name of the column is name. So I'm going to use a single line of text. Name. And don't get confused because we have single line of text and we have multiple line of text. The single line of text is used for 255 words or 255 characters, but the multiple line of text, you have the ability to write more. Maybe you want to give a detailed information. You have the opportunity of using a multiple line of text. So I'm just going to click on more options and click on require that this column contains information. And click on save. So the next thing is to add column, and I want to get the information, like I want to have their email address. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on single line of text and click on email address. Then I'll do the same thing I did for name. I'm just going to click on more options and click on require that this column contains information and click on save. Then the next thing, add column. So this database, like this list, is actually for like a bank. So I'm going to need to get their account number. And in order to get their account number, the data type I'll be using here is actually number. So meaning that you cannot add a text to this particular column. You can only add numbers to this particular column. So I'm just going to click on number and just name it account number. Then I'm going to change this number of decimal places. I don't want to see the number of decimal places in my column. So I'm just going to change it from automatic to zero. Then I'm going to click on more options and change this. You can see something here. We have used thousand separators. I don't want to see comma in my numbers. So I'm just going to change this from yes to no. Then I'm going to click on require that this column contains information and click on save. So the next thing, if you can notice what I said, I talked about like this list being a customer complaint list. So the next column we are to create here is actually a complaint column, which is a multiple line of text, because you want to get the full information of what the customer has said. So it's going to be a multiple line of text and complaints. Then I'm going to click on more options and just click on require that this column contains information and click on save. So after getting all this information about the customers, like the customer's name, the customer's email address, and also the customer's account number, so you want to get something like what you have said to the customer, like a feedback, like after the customer made a complaint, you want to get the feedback of the customer, and also you want to get like a status, what is the status of this complaint? Has this complaint been resolved? Has it not been resolved? So that is the last two information we are going to add to the SharePoint list. So I'm just going to go ahead and click on add column and go for multiple line of text and click on feedback. Then click on more options. Then click on require that this column contains information and click on save. Okay, we are going to add the last column to the SharePoint list, which is our status column, and the data type of this column is choice. So the reason why it is choice is because you have different options to choose if this status of the complaint, if it has been completed, and also if it's in progress, like if you are working on it. So you get to choose that, okay, so that people, other customer personnel will be able to have an information or on how far this complaint, if it has been resolved. So I'm just going to, for the choices, the first choice is going to be open. That is when you automate the Microsoft form, when it comes into the SharePoint list, the complaint is actually open. So the next thing is in progress. That is when you start resolving that particular issue. And maybe you put a pause to it, or you already viewed it. So that is in progress. Then when you complete that customer complaint, you have already resolved the issue they are having. You get to choose the status of complete. So I'm just going to, after doing that, I'm going to go ahead. If you can notice, I have an issue. It is showing just choice theory. So I'm just going to go back to it and copy that completed, delete it, and put it back. So you see, okay, still showing the same thing. Let's try that. Okay, let's go back and just input it back again and see what happens. Okay, great, it works. So in case if you have the same issue like I did, you can be able to sort that out. So I'm just going to, after clicking on more options, I'm just going to make it require that this column contains information. So if you can notice, we have the allow multiple selections. So I'm not going to click on that because I don't want to choose multiple selections. I don't want to choose multiple, which is either I'm choosing in progress and incomplete and complete. It will make it more confusing. So I just want to choose just one particular status. So I'm just going to click on save. Okay. So if you can notice from this particular place, we are not actually seeing our column. The column I just entered just now for status is not actually showing, and that is a network issue. So I'm just going to click on list settings. And if you come down here, you're going to see it status. So it has already been entered. In case you have the same issue, so that you can notice, in case if it's not showing for you, but it's supposed to show here, but just in case if it's not showing for you, so that you can be aware that it's actually there. And for this, if you can check the description of this video, I wrote a blog post on how to create a customer complaint management app with Powerapps. So where you are able to connect this SharePoint list to your application and monitor your customer complaints. So don't forget to hit on the subscribe button and like this video. Thank you very much.